From one fast track to another, I wasn't really expecting much from the Formula Ford race at Brands Hatch. I did, however, end up with a new manager that Renault had provided in the form of Mark Pearce. Now I know what you've got pictured in your heads. You've got this kind of Lionel Hutz type character from The Simpsons. A man of questionable morals and ethics with a very exaggerated track record, totally incompetent, and just the worst when it comes to marketing. But he wasn't. He was the total opposite. He was a tank. A South Yorkshireman from Doncaster that wasn't afraid to tell people what he thought of them. And if he didn't like you, you knew about it. Instantly. Case in point, in the first race of two we did that weekend in Kent, one of the other drivers that I can't remember the name of tried to constantly dive bomb me into the Druid's hairpin lap after lap after lap. By the end of the 7-lap race, my Formula Ford car looked like a banger racer that would have been racing at Hensford that weekend. The dad, a guy from Colchester in Essex who thought he was Danny Dyer in the football factory, came up to me trying to give it the big un, saying, "Every time my boy tried to overtake you, you hit him, use your fucking mirrors." And without even getting up from the lunch table, Mark just went, "Maybe the reason your lad kept hitting Aiden is because he can't fucking drive, now fuck off." It was only our first race weekend together, and I knew I was going to like this guy. He was a White Rose Malcolm Tucker.
Thank you. him. No.
Left rear suspension failure. That's what happened. Of course, try telling everyone at school that. They were convinced it was driver error. I'd also been dumped down a few spots in the championship standings, but not to worry, the damage wasn't as bad as it looked and there were so many rounds left. The guy I would have been fighting for those last two laps was Ben Borman, only in his first race, and already looked bloody quick. Looks like I've got me a rival.